the Suicide Squad, not to be confused with just Suicide Squad. I'd love to say I got a review for this movie, but I haven't seen it yet. But I know somebody who has, so he'll be right back.
Sorry, I didn't hear you come in. You know, I can't hear very well. I might be the world's greatest detective, but you know, rubber on my ears. So anyhow, I'll never forget a couple years ago when I came out on Twitter after a bunch of Trumpers came after him that James Gunn was going to be doing a Marvel movie no more. He was moving on to the brighter pastures, power positive, happier times of a DC film. I only had one question. James Gunn, former Marvel director, can we trust him? I'll never forget when I met James. I went in to film my cameo for the film, but they fired me because I kept saying, I'm Batman. I was supposed to be saying, I'm the Batman. Apparently there's a difference between Batman and the Batman. Just like there's apparently a difference between Suicide Squad and the Suicide Squad. Now sure, you can read the Wikipedia synopsis, and they both basically sound the same, but it's in the way they're done. Sort of like Batman's always more or less the same, but there's a big difference between Michael Keaton and George Clooney. One of them sucks. Where am I going with this? I don't know. Anyhow, the Suicide Squad opens up with some fancy titles, some Johnny Cash, and of course Michael Rooker is playing dead bluesman Johnny Winter. We also have a little cameo of sorts from Nathan Fillion, who listened to that song about a detachable penis one too many times. They're in this movie for the simple reason that it's a James Gunn movie. A lot of people die. There's a sort of badger werewolf who has trouble swimming. Margot Robbie's back as Harley Quinn, and we all remember her from the last Suicide Squad film, wearing too much makeup, not near enough clothes. But here, she's still wearing too much makeup, and now she's dressed like a video game Harley. 15-year-old me would be super stoked. And things just get weirder from there. John Cena shows up, and he's sort of like Captain America if he was less like America's ass, and more like America's asshole. At first, I wasn't even sure if John Cena was in this movie, because I couldn't see him. You know, the mask. So I kept saying, where is he? Where is he? We also have a giant CGI starfish, not to be confused with a butthole. And we also have Sly and the Family Stallone in voice form as Bruce from Jaws. If Bruce from Jaws could sort of talk. And when I say this flick just keeps getting weirder, I'm not lying. Not only do I swear to God, I swear to me. Also, it's pretty cool being the star of your own movies and to be a superhero, but I trade it all in to be some prison henchman, because at some point, because a three-button suit is a little 90s, Mr. Wayne, Harley decides to put on a dress and strangle a prison guard with nothing but her legs. Also, yeah, this movie's super rated R. At one point, two characters shoot bullets at each other at the same time, but one bullet goes through the other bullet, like it's Robin Hood, the cartoon version from Disney, and then it goes right in through and kills a character. You know why? He wasn't the one wearing hockey pads. Truth be told though, this movie just keeps getting battier and battier. All I have to say is to James Gunn is, you're alone. I actually saw this in one of those theaters where you can order food, but I didn't know you were supposed to be quiet. I kept yelling for my server, Rachel! Rachel! Looking for more grub, but she never brought me any. In fact, after this flick ended, all I could think of is James Gunn just proved there are people trying to do good in the DCEU. Sure, there's people who take away the former Suicide Squad from David Ayer because some studio execs just want to watch a cinematic world burn. Personally, the bat's ear is given the Suicide Squad for why known as a smirk. Now, of course, it's going to get overpraised. People are going to call it a masterpiece. Because let's face it, comic book flicks have gotten a little stale. Especially if you compare it to that other flick with almost the same name. In fact, if you happen to be someone who actually liked Suicide Squad, well, you're gonna love the...
HawkSchlock